certain and which we have found now is the missing link, Ta-Seti. In 1962, an American team on the Keith Seal discovered a Pharaonic dynasty south of Egypt which had all the major markings of the Pharaonic dynasty. There they found the palace facades and the palace erects. There they found the falcon god Horus, the son of God, among the Egyptians, the Christ, the first Christ figure. And there they found the krong of the south, unmistakable shape of the krong of the south and the heads of a dozen black pharaohs, even before Aha or Narmamenes or whoever, Scorpion or whoever was the first in Egypt. And there they found the beginnings of the hieroglyphs. In other words, there was now no question that the Nubian was not merely in the evening, he was in the dawn. And it took them 16 years before they announced this. They said it took them 16 years to put the pieces together. But there were some of those pieces, like a stone incense burner from Nubia, that didn't need putting together. It wasn't even broken. But the man in charge of that expedition, Keith Seal, sat on it until he died. And after he died, thank God for his passing at that stage, because were it not for that, we would not have even heard of it. There emerged from the back rooms of the museums things which had been pushed aside, and the whole new picture emerged. And then came people, this could not be true. Lost pharaohs of Nubia, Bruce Williams, it could not possibly be true. And there were attacks on Bruce Williams, and he replied brilliantly. If you read the papers, not only the lost pharaohs of Nubia, but the attack that was made and the brilliant defense point by point, you will know why this is so important at UNESCO. Gamal Abdel Mokhtar, head of the project, when I asked him, I said, sir, I need Diop's paper, Origin of the Egyptians, to publish in the Journal of African Civilization. He said, I will give you permission, Van Sertima, but you have to publish a disclaimer saying that we didn't all agree to it. This is the Egyptian, you know. Doesn't want to be called black. No, sir. Because the black figure had suffered a tremendous loss of status in the world. We had been turned slaves. So that when Count Volney, even in that late stage, walked among them, and they had already become mixed with many peoples, he said, it is clear to me that this is a Negro race, and that we owe so much of our arts and sciences to these people we have made our slaves, the objects of our contempt. He was troubled by that guilt. And there were so many who went there with fixed ideas, like the man who wrote, Budge, who wrote the Egyptian dictionary, at first thinking they were Caucasoids or Afro-Asiatic, and when he started to write his dictionary, he began to realize all the roots of these things lie in Africa. And Gerald Massey saw that. And you look at the language. Khenti means south. And do you know what it also means? It means first. Those people south of them were first. And he created one of the names for Africa. Africa came through many names. Sometimes they were called Ethiopians and Libyans and all sorts of things. But there is a name that is an Egyptian, Afruika. It was not for the continent, but it was for the people south of them. Afruika meaning beginnings. And they call their people Kemiu, the dark people, the black people, Kemet, the black land. And they said the reason why it was calling it the black land is because the earth is black. I don't know what they're talking about. Everything had to be turned upside down to make it correct. The black does not fit here.